Hello, we're going to look at how to integrate Rust code as a Python module. The article I've written to support this is on redandgreen.co.uk. If you go to the Rust section, you'll find it. And then on the link, www.maturin.rs tutorial, get this tutorial. And it helps you to code a guessing game that uses a Rust module with Python. So, first thing we're going to do is this, which is create a, I'm going to create a library rather than a binary. So there we go. So within my just the reason why it says documents Rust is just my directory name. So now if we go to CD guessing game, we should see this directory structure. So tree. There we go. We've got cargo, and then we've got src directory with lib.rs inside it. Just like. Okay. Next, we want to put all of the information into our cargo.toml file. So we've already got a cargo.toml file, but we just need to edit it. We've got package. So that, and I'm just copy. We've got lib, name guessing game. CDYlib is necessary to produce the shared library for Python to import from. Dependencies, which is rand, we can do some random number stuff. Dependency.pyo3, that's again something else that you use Python and shared objects. So let's go back here, paste that in. Done. Next, we have to create a file called, let me just show you, pyproject.toml, which is at the same level as cargo.toml. So do that, and then we will paste in build system, tell it to use Maturin as the build backend, which Python accepts. And then we choose. So copy and paste really just for this for the time being until we go back and get down into the weeds. So nvpyproject.toml. Okay, that's what you just saw. Pasted that into pyproject.toml, which is a file. So cargo.toml. Anybody from Python background, cargo.toml gets created by Rust to help you, but the pyproject.toml doesn't. See Rust normally that really by default. Right. Maturin objects can also use. Presumably that would actually create you a pyproject. Right, so let's create our virtual environment. So Python 3 hyphen standard procedure for writing Python code. Created it. Now we need to activate it. You see we've got guessing game showing up down here. So our virtual environment is activated. Now it's activated. We store Turin into it. Do with that. Clear the screen. So go pip freeze. Freeze. And we see that Maturin is installed. Pyproject.toml we've already done. Okay, so yeah, so it's just still talking about the pyproject.toml, which we've already done. Right, so next we actually need to do the Rust code, which it's part of the guessing game from the Rust book. So I'm really not going to dwell on this because this is more a demo of Maturin if we just edit lib.rs, which has just basically got some placeholder code. So we get rid of that. And we insert guessing game code. Save that. The guessing game code basically takes some user input and it tries to, it tells you whether your guess is higher or lower than the secret number, which is between 1 and 100, because I know what upper band exclusive. We're using the pair trait for the numbers. So this is the important bit, guessing game. So the function's called guessing game in our Rust code. But guess the number, sorry, the module is called the guessing game, but the function is called guess the number. So guess the number. That's important because that's what actually gets called when we run our Python code. So we'll be importing guessing game as a import module, and then the function method will be guess the number. Important. And if you're not new to Rust code, then return OK with type of a. Right, so in theory, we're ready to run Maturin develop. So let's try and run Maturin. Failed. Can't find Cargo.toml. I'm running it. That's interesting. So you need to run it from the same directory as Cargo. That's no surprise, really. So we've got a little chain link, we've got the Python snake, and then we've got radar, the satellite dish, and building the wheel for the distribution. Good, so that's built it. And all it really needs to do. So we can just do it from the interpreter. So we just need Python and import guessing game. Run Python, import guessing game, and then we actually run. And there we go. So should guess 55, 88, 67. I win. There we go. So that's a very quick demo of using Maturin to compile Rust code, which can be then used as a module within Python. Obviously, guessing game is a kind of a toy example, and way bigger use cases for compiling code that you can then call from Python. Say NumPy is the classic example that gets quoted. So yeah, congratulations, you've successfully created a Python module implemented entirely in Rust thanks to Py03 and Maturin. This demonstrates how easy it is to get started with Maturin, but keep on reading to learn more about additional features. So yeah, there we go. That is a very quick demo of how to write some code in Rust and then allow it to be used from Python. And if you want to see the read-up, it's all here. I've put in some screenshots, so that's kind of the guessing game. That's what your tree should look like. That's the code that you've just seen, Rust code, which gets put into lib.rs. And the pyproject and the, that was Cargo. That's the toml. And yeah, thank you for reading. And if you want any good, easy to use, no BS Linux web hosting, I can really recommend Webdock. And if you click that link, it will really help me. Because I've got a good deal with them, but it's on the condition that I tell everyone how good they are. And I'm being genuine here. They are really good. It's brilliant. It's no fuss. Everything's really quick, neat, clean. Everything works perfectly. And this site is hosted with Webdock. So this is not really a paid promotion, but I'm just saying I host my website with Webdock. So if you're looking for some hosting, I can really recommend. So thanks for watching, and back soon. Thanks. Thumbs up and subscribe as well. Yeah, thank you. Really helps the days with the old.